Now we have clearly understood dot product and cross product. Dot product is also called scalar product because it gives a scalar quantity. Cross product is also called a vector product because we get a vector quantity. Not only I cross I, A cross B means not only AB sine theta but also a unit vector. So that's why it is called a vector product. Now any vector A can have components AX, AY, AZ can be written as AXI, AYJ, AZK that we have seen with the unit vectors. Now let us say let ABC be arbitrary vector magnitudes of ABC. So ABC are three vectors and their magnitude is A, B and C then. So this is some properties of vectors. So A cross B and this is bracket B plus C. So how can we write? Simply we can write A cross B plus A cross C. So if any vector A is crossed with sum of two vectors, so we can write cross product with first vector plus cross product with second vector. Now if we multiply this S with a scalar, A with a scalar, S is a scalar. What is a scalar? Let us say 3. 3 is a number, it is a scalar quantity. We multiplied this A with a scalar quantity, then cross product with B. So what we get? A cross SB or S into A cross B. Because a scalar can be multiplied with any of these vectors. So this will not make any change whether we multiply first with the scalar or multiply another quantity with the scalar then cross product. So it does not make any difference in the vector. Let theta be the smaller of the two angles between A and B then. Okay. So what we have in that case? A dot B is equal to B dot A is equal to AX plus AY plus AZ is equal to AB cos theta. So now what is this? What is the meaning of this? This is again the cross dot product, not cross. This is your dot product. So how can we write dot product? So we have two vectors A and B. Suppose A is equal to A1i, A2j and A3k. Okay. So how can we write this here? B is equal to B1i plus B2j plus B3k. In this way we can write. Now if we have to dot multiply or both of this, so how can we dot multiply? So dot multiply A, let me write this vector A dot B. So how can we multiply? So if you see, so only terms with I into I, so if you multiply you get 9 terms. I into I, J I, K I, again I J, J J, K K and K I, K J and K K. So I term will remain, I and I term will remain. So what we get? A1, B1 and I dot I, and I is 1. So we get A1, B1. Similarly, IJ will 0, IK will 0. Now let us multiply this one. A1 in this is IJ will 0. So here we get J and J. So that means this is 1. So A2, B2. Now K and J will be 0. Now let us multiply this with 3 terms. So I and K will give us 0. J and K will give us 0. K and K will give us something. And K and K is 1. So A3, B3. So this is the way we multiply the dot product. This is the result we get for the dot product. So A, वेक्टर ए डॉट वेक्टर बी इज इक्वल टू ए वन बी वन ए टू बी टू प्लस ए थ्री बी थ्री. सो हेयर सेम ए डॉट बी और बी डॉट ए इज इक्वल टू ए एक्स बी एक्स ए वाई बी वाई ए जेड बी जेड. सो आई हैव रिटन 1 2 3. यू कैन राइट एक्स इंस्टेड ऑफ 1. सो ए एक्स बी एक्स ए वाई बी वाई ए जेड बी जेड. एंड वी हैव सीन दिस इज इक्वल टू ए बी कॉस थीटा. नाउ क्रॉस प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दीज टू. इफ यू सी दिस साइन, देर इज अ साइन. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस साइन? दिस साइन इज वी आर टेकिंग ओनली मैग्नीट्यूड. वी आर टेकिंग ओनली मैग्नीट्यूड. वी आर नॉट कंसिडरिंग अबाउट द डायरेक्शन. दीज टू लाइन मीन्स वी आर टेकिंग ओनली द मैग्नीट्यूड. ओके. एंड दिस साइन इज कॉल्ड मॉड. ओके. मॉड मीनिंग वी आर कंसिडरिंग ओनली द मैग्नीट्यूड. वी आर नॉट कंसिडरिंग द डायरेक्शन. ओके. सो नाउ लेट अस डू द क्रॉस मल्टीप्लीकेशन. सो ए क्रॉस बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी क्रॉस ए. वाई? बिकॉज इफ यू रिमेंबर वी हैव मल्टीप्लाइड दिस आई क्रॉस जे इज इक्वल टू के. वी हैव सीन दिस. बट इफ वी रिवर्स जे क्रॉस आई, सो वॉट डिड वी गेट? वी गेट माइनस के. लेट अस टेक माइनस दिस साइड. सो माइनस जे क्रॉस आई इज इक्वल टू के. सो नाउ दिस के एंड दिस के पुटिंग द वैल्यू इक्वल. सो आई क्रॉस जे इज इक्वल टू माइनस जे क्रॉस आई. ओके. सो सिमिलरली हेयर ए क्रॉस बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी क्रॉस ए. सो दिस इज रिवर्स ऑफ दैट. ए क्रॉस बी इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी क्रॉस ए. नाउ लीव दिस थिंग. नाउ लेट अस लर्न हाउ कैन वी सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम. How can we do the vector multiplication? So let us write first this the value. What is the value of A? So A is AX I AY J plus AZ K. So this was A. Now what is B? B is equal to this BX I plus BY J and BZ K. So this is B. So how do we multiply? So this there is a way of multiplication by which we multiply. We first write the unit vectors here I J K. Okay. This thing is called a determinant. Determinant. Okay. Determinant will give us some value. So this is determinant. Now first vector. What is first vector? First vector is A. So we write what is associated with I. What is associated with I? AX. What is associated with J with in A? This is AY. What is associated with K? AZ. So this is we write. Now with B. What is associated in B? Second vector? BX. What is associated here? BY. What is associated here? BZ. So this is the way we write. Now let us solve this determinant. So this is how we write the determinant. See here. I, J, K, AX, AY, AZ, BX, BY, PZ. There can be numbers. Suppose if we have A is equal to 3I plus 2J plus 4k, and if we have B equal to 6i plus j plus 2k, if we have, then how will we write? We will write simply I j k. And what is associated with I? 3. What is associated with 2? Associated with k? 4. Here 6. Here only 1. Here 2. Suppose if we have negative here, then we will write minus 4. This is the way how we write these things, determinants. So now the determinants are written. So now let us do the multiplication. So how do we multiply? So first we write I. What is the first term? I. Then we write second term j. Then we write third term k. I, j, k, all three terms are written here. And with that, what we do with this I, j, k? So let us multiply this. If we take I, so we forget all these things. Okay, we forget what is coming below and what is in front of I. So we multiply this with this. So ay into bz, ay bz minus this, this cross multiplication, by az, by az. So this is the term with I, ay bz minus by az. Now let us solve for j. We are solving for j. So plus, there is a plus sign, but for j we cross multiply. Let me remove this. So again we have to cross multiply ax bz minus bx az, but for middle one this is reversed, the order is reversed. We first multiply this bx az, bx az. So we get bx az minus ax bz, ax bz. Okay, same thing you see, az bx minus bz ax. Only thing you have to remember is for j the cross multiplication is reversed. Now for third part, third part is we simply write k. We forget all these things. Now we have to cross multiply this to this, ax by, okay, minus bx ay. So this is the way we multiply, this is the way we multiply these things. Only thing is that this a, this ay bz minus by az, this is correct for I. For j it is reversed, for j it is reversed. Ax bz is here, first we will multiply bx az, then we multiply in reverse ax bz. So for j it is reversed. So this is the vector multiplication. Now these are some identities. A dot b cross c is equal to b dot c cross a or c dot a cross b. This is the vector identity that you have to remember. And cross product of all three is given by this. A cross b cross c is equal to, suppose if there are three vectors, then how will we do the cross multiplication? So just to do cross multiplication, a dot c b minus a dot b c. Remember, this is a dot product, so this becomes a scalar. This becomes a scalar and there is no dot product. This is a vector. So multiplication without any dot product, multiplication with a scalar and a vector is always a vector. Okay, again this is a scalar, this is a vector, and multiplication is between scalar and vector is always a vector, and we are subtracting or adding two vectors. So this is the way how do we do the cross or dot multiplication of vectors. Suppose we have two vectors a and b. Now we have to add these two vectors. This is 3i plus 2j. I have taken with 2 only, we can add third as well. So this is 1i plus 6j. So how we add? We add only I with I, j with j. So 3 and 4, 1 is 4i, and this becomes 2 plus 6 is 8j. So this is the addition of vector. Similarly, we can subtract. For subtracting, I minus I, j minus j. This is the way we add or subtract vectors.